2018 Volkswagen Atlas has climbed to a part where everyone is looking at what it's doing. After all, if you are rolling in Silver Lake, you'd better have a good reason to back it up. The Atlas is a product of VW's failed attempt to regain a huge stake in the American market, and has been stalled not just because of corporate malfeasance, but also the drastic shift away from cars and minivans. Midsize SUVs have been the family transportation devices of the 2010s, decades after the last transporter / microbus / Vanagon left US showrooms. The Atlas doesn't go under much counter, however, because it has very mainstream rivals in its sights. But in the crowded field, the Atlas has to not only be very good but also bring something new. Every Atlas gets Apple CarPlay, Android Auto, or MirrorLink, depending on your smartphone. This is good because navigation comes only on the most expensive SEL and SEL Premium modules and is therefore bundled with a lot of stuff you probably don't want. Still, although the most basic Atlas gets a bright new 8-inch touchscreen to control the infotainment functions. And it's backed by a faster processor and a smaller unit in other recent VWs, finally making it one of the more stable and easy-to-use systems out there. Those who cannot afford the SEL Premium also get the new digital cockpit, a 12.3-inch TFT screen in place of physical gauges and pretty much a simpler version of Audi's virtual cockpit. But VW apparently spent most of the Atlas interior budget because, despite its MQB origin shared with the Golf and more recent VW introductions, many pieces inside feel as cost-cut as the budget-conscious Jetta and Passat do. The door pocket and glove box aren't lined with fabric as they are on the $20,000 Golf, either, so bottles and paint rattle when you're driving along. Many surfaces other than the golf dash pad are hard when you smack your knee against them.